Today I want to show you why it might be a good idea to use keyword sets inside of Lightroom. What's up, nerds? Today is Wednesday, and Wednesday means it's photo of the week day. Today we have a really cool one brought in by JenFish504. I just love this image. If you know anything about me or Jack Thatcher, we love photographing water. And it's really difficult to get the perfect amount of texture in water. And this image is a perfect example of getting just the right amount of shutter speed to show some movement, but still get the blur and get some texture. But I also love the rich gold colors in here. Nice job, Miss JenFish 504. Go ahead and check out her feed. As well, if you want to participate in next week's Photo of the Week, be sure to follow us on Instagram at PhotoNerdsUnite and use the hashtag PNFL so we can see what you guys are up to and feature some of our favorite images each Wednesday. But as far as today's video goes, this has come up in a YouTube comments a few times and I just haven't had a chance to make a video on it. So today is your lucky day. We're going to talk about keyword sets. It's something that's easy to overlook. Even if you're using keywords, it's a good chance that you're probably not using keyword sets, but after today, you'll probably find them to be pretty useful, especially when you're keywording things that are pretty common in your life. And I'm gonna show you some examples of exactly what I'm talking about. So let's jump into Lightroom and see what the hell it is I'm talking about. So let's start off with a little family photo of me, my wife, my two beautiful little girls who look nothing like me. I still haven't met the FedEx man, but I have a feeling something's going on. Anyways, I've got a photo here, and anytime I want to take pictures like this, I'm going to come in here and keyword those photos, but I don't want to have to individually keyword these the long way. So instead, what I've done is I've created a keyword set. Now you can find this under the list in your library module under the list keywording. And when I open this up, you'll notice that there's a section here called keyword set. And if I open up my keyword set, I've already made a few in here. I can go to the one that I made, which is basically my immediate family. And when I click on it, you'll see that I'm given 9 options or 9 boxes. That's probably the one downside to this. You can only put 9 keywords. So if for some reason you had more than that, you're gonna have to create a second keyword set because this will only let you store 9. Luckily for me, my immediate family is not larger than 9. So if I had a photo like this and I wanted to keyword some people, all I'd have to do is look at the people in the photograph and begin tagging by just clicking on the tag that's associated with whatever's whoever in this example. So I have me, my wife, my daughter, and my other daughter. And you can see every time I click on one of these options in the keyword tag list, that name is being added to the list. And then when I go down to keyword list, I will see that those names have actually been tagged. Now, there is a catch to this. And the catch is if you've already created keyword tags, your keyword set has to be the same. I'm going to show you an example here. Under who, I've named myself my full name, Adam Furtado. But in my keyword set, I only have myself listed as Adam. So when I use this tag and go down to my list, you'll see at the top here that it actually applied my name, Adam, but it didn't associate with my full name. And that's because the keywords are not identical. So the only way that this will actually organize your keywords correctly is if the set matches the list. So if I want to fix this, it's really easy to do. I can go ahead and tag this photo with the tag I actually want to use and then remove the tag that got applied, which was just Adam in this sense. And now I'm going to right click on that tag to delete it. And then I need to go up to the keyword set and edit it so that I don't run into this problem again in the future. So what I'm going to do is click on this little drop down arrow here and go to edit set. And when I do, this section will pop up. And so what I need to do is modify my name so that it's Adam Furtado instead of just Adam. Actually, I can save these changes by just clicking change. And now those changes will take effect. So if I look in my keyword set now, you can see that it's Adam Furtado, not just Adam. Now you can make any set for any reason. Just here's another example. If I go back to the grid, I've got this picture here from Yosemite. I often frequent Yosemite a couple times a year. So I've made a keyword set just for Yosemite National Park. So when I click on Yosemite National Park, you'll see that the 9 keywords have changed from the names in my immediate family to locations inside of Yosemite National Park that I often like to photograph. So in this example, I'm gonna tag Yosemite National Park. I want that to be in there. And then this is a photo of Upper and Lower Yosemite Falls. So I'm gonna click Upper Falls, Lower Falls, and just like that, I've given this photograph the 3 keywords that are most important to me, and I don't have to type anything in. And if I go into my keyword list, you'll see that everything has been tagged correctly except for Upper and Lower Falls. And for the reason, because I never created that in my list. So what I need to do is go to where, under California, Yosemite, and drag Upper Falls into there, and then drag Lower Falls into there. And now anytime I use Upper or Lower Falls on another photograph, they'll automatically go into the category that I wanted them to go. But if you want to create a brand new set, all you have to do is click on this drop down menu, go to Edit Set, start typing something new. I'm just going to use some simple things like cat, dog, bird. I could keep typing in anything else that I wanted. I'm gonna go ahead and just erase these other things. And so here we go. And now I need to rename this keyword set so that way I have it for something new. So all I'm gonna do is open up this little drop-down menu and save current settings as a new preset. And I'm gonna call this one animals and hit create and then hit change and I'm good to go. And so now if I open up my keyword set, I can see some of the locations I've been to. I can see my immediate family, but now I have this animal one. And when I click on animal, I have 3 out of 9 options. And if I wanna switch from animals back to immediate family, I just open up this dropdown and boom, there you have it. So that's using keyword sets. Really easy to do, simple to make, highly effective, and you can make as many of these as you want. And it's really gonna speed up your keywording workflow, especially if you're keywording similar things or people over and over and over again. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and until next time, have a great day, everybody.